talked about lots of things.
You really
but
did.
Mainly about the release of his new print, Elf mm-hmm. Augen, which is German for 11 eyes, if you didn't know. And then we also talked about his two new artworks, which we have on display in the gallery. So that was really exciting.
That's really good.
Yeah.
Well, so tonight, so we've got we've got Brandon in two sections. We'll mm-hmm. I'll take a break. We'll play the first half of your interview, do a little more painting, and then we'll come back, do that, and then I'll finish up as usual.
Yeah.
And see if I can finish the painting. It's always good to be able to do that.
It always is really fun.
So this week everybody's been asking me, what are you gonna paint? And I swear, all week I've gone, I have no idea. And I woke up this morning, still didn't have any idea. This afternoon, still didn't have any idea. This evening, still didn't have any idea. So I finally put up the canvas and I go, okay, and I looked up there, and I don't know, Arturo, if you can grab a picture of those, but I looked at some of my early sunflower paintings, and I thought, man, it's just a gray, blah day in Texas. Let's bring a little sunshine in.
It's kind of dreary weather here.
It is, so I'm just gonna do a miniature version of sunflowers tonight.
Good.
Now, I hope I can get it done. One of the tricky things with them is every single one of those little petals I have to put on.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm hoping I'll make it, but hey, you know, dangerously.
I think you can do it.
You think so?
You got the genius
you believe?
Behind you. I believe in you.
Yeah, of course, it's that, yeah. Yeah, okay, well, why don't I go ahead and get started with that,
okay.
And then we'll just, in a little bit, we'll take a break and watch you and Brandon
yes.
talking about what he's working on. Sound good?
Sounds great.
Okay, Cecilia, if you can hit the music. Yeah, there we go. Oh, it is good to be here. Got some new incense in. See how this smells. So tonight I'm not gonna do a lot of talking while I'm painting. Kind of been mixing it up lately. But one thing I always like to start with when I'm doing another painting for those painters of you is just get the underpainting done. And I'm going to do that with the special thing I've shown before. It's called Liz's Black. And it's a mixture of alizarin crimson and French ultramarine blue. And it is magic. So that's where we'll start. The other thing I'm gonna do tonight is, I'm just gonna make this up. This is no place real. I'm just gonna create a little vignette here and see what my crazy brain comes up with. I'm gonna turn the music up a little bit. Ah, there we go. All right, let's get started. Thank you. right, there it is. So one thing I am working on is my brother Marcus and I, who's our director, we are producing an instructional video series on the oil technique. So a lot of the things that I'm using tonight, we will be covering in depth. And so we're about halfway through the editing process and look forward to sharing that with everybody when it's ready. But I'm excited about sharing some of these techniques I've been using for the last 25 years. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Some titanium white. Okay, no gray skies on this painting today. We're gonna do blue, bright blue. Get some clouds in there. Nice fluffy clouds for a beautiful summer day. Pretty happy day there. There we go. Okay. Thank you. It's looking happy so far. You think so? Yeah. That brings a smile to my face. All right. Thank you. All right, so there's the first stage. So obviously I'm just making a really beautiful summer day, completely different than what it is outside, but that's the beauty of painting. You can create whatever you want, whatever's in your mind and your heart and your soul. So then the next stage, I'll start putting in the sunflowers and getting those built out. And we'll just, by the time this is done, it's just gonna be a happy day with those sunflowers waving in the breeze. So right now what we're gonna do is we're gonna play the first half of the interview that Grace had with Brandon Boyd, the lead singer of Incubus and one of our amazing artists. I tell the story when I started painting, gosh, it's hard to believe, but over 20 years ago, Incubus had come out with their first album. And for whatever reason, I totally resonated with it. And I listened, that first year in the studio when I was painting, I probably listened to that easily 300 or 400 times. And that was in the days they had cassettes. And I literally wore the cassette out at the end of the first year. But it's funny how things, synchronicity, things come into play that you would never expect, and yet you learn to expect them to happen. So about 4 years ago, we were at the LA Art Fair, and someone introduced us. They knew Brandon Boyd, said, "Would you like to meet him? He's a great artist." I said, "Hell yeah." And so we met him at the fair and just totally hit it off. We looked at his work, and it's kind of amazing because his work is equally good in the visual arts as it is in his musical vision. And so now we represent Brandon Boyd, and it's just really cool how everything comes full circle. So for right now, I'll take a little break, and let's turn it over to Grace and Brandon.
Hello everyone, and welcome to our Instagram Live interview with Brandon Boyd. We are so excited to have everyone joining us today. We've got a great interview lined up. So Brandon will be joining us in just a few minutes. He is connecting from LA, and obviously we are here at the gallery in Dallas. But we're very excited for what we're going to be talking about today. We have two new artworks of Brandon's, and I know he's been working on quite a lot. And then of course we also have the Elf Organ print, which is available on our website. We're on. Brandon, is that you?
I think so.
Yay, we're all together again.
How are you?
Good, I'm good. How are you? How is everything in LA? I know you've been busy painting in your yacht.
Yeah. Everything's been going well, thanks. How are you guys in Dallas?
We're great. We've been pretty busy. We had a bit of a cold spell 2 weeks ago now, but of course, if you don't like the weather in Texas, just wait 5 minutes. We're having a beautiful sunny day today, so very lucky.
I'm glad you guys are okay. Yeah, we were concerned about you out there. Hey, look, it's Jen DeSisto.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Jen. How are you?
You have to interview Jen.
No.
She's the main one we're interviewing today. So I wanted to talk about, obviously, we're really excited that, we're interviewing you again because it's been a while since our last one. I think that was back in September of 2020. And a lot has changed since then. But, we have two of your new artworks that arrived. On the ground running, and Polyamethyst number one, and then of course we also have your print, Elf Algon. So I want to talk a little bit about that. I actually did some research and I found that Elf Algon is German for 11 eyes. Is there any special meaning as to why you chose that?
Because there were 11 eyes in the painting.
Make it simple.
Right. Being a language that I don't speak, I wish I spoke the language. Yeah, I have the basics. I can say hello, goodbye, please, and 11 eyes now.
Well, that's all you really need to know.
Yeah.
So, also, the use of eyes, it's kind of been a common theme in your artwork. And then in the two new ones that we have in the gallery, those also have eyes in them. So can you kind of tell us a little bit about maybe why you chose that?
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of reasons, I suppose, why eyes are finding their way continually into my paintings. both open eyes, but also closed eyes. I love to paint people in kind of contemplative states. So a lot of the more figurative work, you'll notice that someone is either closing one eye or covering one eye or closing both eyes. And then there are sort of disembodied eyes around them as witnesses, so to speak. I'm still kind of in the process of understanding what I'm doing as well. So it's fun to speculate while you're kind of in process. But I think that what I'm attempting to capture is a kind of the nebulous idea of consciousness and how consciousness shows up in certain places, sometimes more than others, and consciousness as it pertains to human experience, and also within human experience, the ever-present witness, because there is always sort of a witness, spiritually speaking. And so the eyes are kind of a way of alluding to the witness, whether it's the person that's being painted, who's turning inward and a different set of eyes are opening, perhaps, or maybe they are being seen from a different set of eyes that they're not aware of, or that you could also get into more of like a culturally paranoid part of it, and before kind of idea where there's always somebody watching, that type of thing, but I don't spend too much time there.
Well, I really like that. That sounds very interesting.
Somebody did ask if your art has changed since COVID.
Oh, has your art changed since COVID?
And if so, how?
That's a really good question. I would say yes. And I would say yes, it's definitely changed. The ways in which it's changing, I say the art is changing, are still kind of revealing themselves to me. I've been writing an album while I've been painting that year, and the album is almost finished. And now that I'm having this chance to kind of step back from the lyrics a little bit and kind of get a sense of what my kind of unconscious upwellings were doing while I was writing these songs, there are tinges of sort of deep loneliness and deep longing. I think there's probably obvious reasons for that type of a thing, because it was such a strange, kind of isolated in so many ways. There's also kind of a longing for touch, like actual physical connection. So much of that was lost.
Absolutely, yes.
And that kind of longing, such a, you know, sort of just base human need to be touched by another human being, or just to hug your friends or hug your family or your loved ones. So much of that was lost over the last year. Fortunately, it's only temporary. So there was also, like, there's been tinges of hope interjected in amongst well. So as far as like the visual aspects of what has changed, there are a lot more of those eyes popping up, which I think has something to do with the fact that the last year was so deeply contemplative, and not necessarily because I wanted it to be that way. It just kind of ended up that way. I I entirely just stayed home, and I, in a lot of ways, so blessed to be in a position where I was able to do that, to stay home and, you know, stay safe. And so my bubble, as far as like the people who I was interacting with, was really, really small. And so I suppose a reason that a bunch of those sort of witnesses or those eyes were popping up in my paintings and stuff is because, that was all I kind of had. It was a lot of time in dreamland, like almost like a liminal space, you know, like an in-between state. And so I off in all these different directions, both inward and outward and everywhere I could, just to kind of like absorb this strange experience of the last year. How have you fared over the last year?
We have fared fairly well-ish. I mean, obviously, you know, being in Texas, it's a very different story, but thankfully, we're very lucky to have each other through all of this. And I think, you know, one of the great things about being human is no matter where we are in the world, especially during this time, no matter who we are or where we are, we're all kind of processing this same emotion of going through the last year together and experiencing that in relatively the same way. And however we choose to express that, that emotion will be conveyed through many forms of art, whether it be music, painting, photography, sculpture, all of that. So it's very special, but in a way sad to share the universal experience. But like you said, having those little gleams of hope everywhere is something that keeps us all together, just like the great art keeps us all together. So very lucky to have the people around us, near us.
That makes me think of this past year being as hard as it was for everybody in the world, but you know, some people more than others. But what an incredible time for art. What an incredible opportunity for our sort of collective experience to be mirrored in both music and visual art and film. And I know that people, a lot of, like, for instance, in the art of movie making, a lot of movies, most movies didn't happen just because there's so many restrictions.
Right, they couldn't be there.
Yeah. My girlfriend went into a very small, very safe COVID bubble and went to, they all got tested like every 3 days, and they went and they made a movie, which they're kind of at the last stages of editing right now, but I've seen these rough cuts of it, and it takes place during COVID, like in the film, it's part of the plot. And fantastic movie. I can't tell you the title of it, but you guys, I'll definitely be talking about it when it's ready to be talked about, because it's definitely worth seeing. But the film beautifully captured. And then the other example, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, is my old friend Brian Bowen Smith put out a book called Drive-Bys. And he got in his 1950s pickup truck and he drove across the country back and forth taking pictures of his friends, as well as a bunch of people he just met along the way.
That sounds very lovely.
You should check it out. It's called BBS Drive-Bys. And
I bought it. It's amazing.
Yes, so I have our director, Kristen Rivas, here with me, and she says that she's on that as well.
It's so good. He really did a wonderful job of capturing the moment, not only the strangeness of it and the isolation, but what pokes through in his work more than anything is like there's like the inherent hope and the of human beings, even amongst one of the most challenging times in recent memory. So anyway, yeah.
Well, I wanted to we're going to move the camera over a bit, and we're going to go to your first artwork, Polyamorphous number one. And you've done two of these, but one of them is here. And obviously we have the eyes, which we just talked about. But what I really like about this is you have used a different color for the first time, which is more of a pinky hue. And it's very different from your other artworks. I really like it. Is there, you know, what was it like to make this? And was there any reasoning behind choosing a lighter pink color?
You know, I don't know if there was real directionality in going with different color palettes. It was more, it's one thing as well, as far as my painting is concerned over the last year, is that I started to knowingly break some of my own patterns. I allow certain to come up because they come up, you know, they kind of push through to the surface, and I would happily just do lines over and over and over. I'm a little bit nuts with that, as indicated by the painting behind you before.
Yes, wow. It's one of my favorite artworks of yours.
Thank you. I can go with lines like for the rest of time. There's something really hypnotic about it to me and fun. But I really started noticing some of my deeper patterns and wanting to kind of break them. So I started just smearing in different color palettes to see what would happen. And it kind of worked. I do enjoy that painting. I also love saying it. Isn't it fun to say polyamethyst?
Ready.
Okay, that was the first segment of the Brandon Boyd interview. I hope everyone enjoyed it. I know I really loved interviewing him, and I'm really excited for you guys to watch the second part.
And yes, and Brandon said he really enjoyed interviewing with
you. Yes, he did.
Yes, he did. He said she's very pretty. not in that accent.
No, yeah. Different one, more That's, Californian.
No, it's good. It's kind of good because you guys got it a little more in depth than we normally have time
yeah,
for.
Yeah, no.
And the second half is equally
It's equally as good. It'll be a good thing to watch.
Yeah, so just briefly tell us what is the edition that he's launching?
So the edition that he's launching is are his Elf Augen prints, mm-hmm. which is German for 11 eyes.
Of course.
It's available
of
on,
course.
Yeah, of course, the SLG website. But the eyes have become a really prominent thing throughout his artwork, like his two new artworks that mm-hmm. we have here at the gallery. They both feature eyes, and it's just something he's kind of exploring and creating while cool. he's painting in his yurt.
In his yurt.
Being in California.
Do you guys know what a yurt is?
Anyone know?
I do now. It's the Mongolians, the big circular tent.
Yeah.
But Brandon has a luxury yurt. I mean, this isn't, you know, this is not like a
It's almost like a mini house.
It's a mini, very cool house that's round and cool. But, okay, well, I'll let you take a break. I got to get to work.
You do have to get to work.
I got
to
earn my
I want to see some sunflowers on here
pay.
In
okay.
the next 10 minutes.
You want to see them. Okay.
TikTok.
TikTok. Okay, so I'll paint a little bit. We'll do the Brandon, and then we'll come back and wrap
okay.
up.
Okay,
so let's
great.
Go.
Great. Let's
All right,
do
Grace.
It.
Yay.
Thanks, JD.
You're welcome. Always got to start with our incense. I learned this from studying Leonardo da Vinci. I've always liked incense, but Leonardo was, in my opinion, probably the greatest genius as far as breadth of his, you know, what he did and explored painting. He did mechanics, he did war machines, he did all kinds of things. But when he was painting, he really believed in stimulating all the senses. So he had incense burning, he had candles. He had, in those days, obviously, they didn't have even record players or CD players or anything. So he would literally hire local musicians to come in and play music while he was painting. And he'd have people all around, and just it was kind of like this. It was a real deal, and he just loved that interaction. So I stole that from Leonardo, among other things. But here we are. Let's just bless ourselves with this incense. And Santi, if you can turn up the music. Yeah, let's get it up there. This will be, oh yeah, crank it up. Let's go, get it going. More. Let's rock this place. There we go. Yeah, good. All right, time to start bringing these things home. Can you turn up a little bit more? No extra charge. Keep going. More. Let's go. Is that full blast? That's good. That'll work. Mike, how you doing? I like your hat, man.
You.
You look like an artist.
I'm a
wannabe. Yeah, that's where it starts. It just starts
you're
here. I'm glad you're here. Looking forward to tomorrow night, meeting the artist from Aspen.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm just going to keep on painting this beautiful day that only exists in my mind and our presence right now. Oh, man, I found out today that Sunday is daylight savings time. I freaking hate that. You gotta get up an hour earlier. I like to sleep in. There we go. Perfect. Thank you, Santi. All right, let's get some sunflower action going here. See you. to me. Oh, yeah. I love that song. That's so cool. Let's do some pedals. Put the pedal to the metal. Put the metal to the pedal. I'll see what I can pedal. So the other thing I'm doing today is every once in a while I like to paint from all my scraps. Now I added one new color, but everything I'm doing in this painting tonight is all from scraps that have been here for the last couple of months. So it's just fun. It's a challenge and makes it a little more interesting for me. All right, but there's some good scraps, man. Look at that. That's a big pile of paint right there. Yeehaw. What happens is on the edges it gets kind of crusty, but inside it's still good and lush. So here we go. Let's start putting some petals on this painting, making these sunflowers. Just gotta dig under there. Woo! Yummy. Thank you. So good of John Mayer to join us tonight. Thank you, John. It's always great to have live music in the studio. Oh, a little Beck. Here we go. Oh, yeah. So I'm getting ready to get toward the end of this, and but one thing I want to point out. So this is pretty much the way the sunflowers would look in the field. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to add something that I don't know why I started doing to all my sunflower paintings, but I think I do know why. So yellow, because it's predominantly the predominant bright color. Purple is the complement. So I just like to put these little purple jewels in the middle of the sunflowers, and it makes them vibrate. So I'm going to add those, and then we'll take a break for Brandon. And I've got one little final touch to put when we come back from Brandon's second half. So here we go. Let's mix up some French ultramarine blue and a little dioxazine purple. And we'll add some white. This is the white and the purple are the two tubes that I'm allowing myself to not be scraps tonight. Everything else is from the scrap pile, just for fun. But I needed some fresh white for this. Okay, I got the handy tube roller. These things are gold. They really are. I mean, they just make it so much easier, especially with these big tubes. All right, so let's get some jewels going here. And we're gonna do this pretty fast and loose. It will definitely give it, start setting these flowers to vibrating. And again, it's not there in nature, but I don't know why it feels like it should be. So since it's my painting, I can choose that. And I've never had anybody come up to me and say, man, what are those purple things in there? Those aren't in the sunflowers.
Does the center have some sort of texture to it?
It's texture, yeah. But that's kind of looks like that if you blend it all. Yeah. This is pretty accurate. This? No, there's no like center thing, but I don't know. I just like it, so. And it gets the yellow, sets the yellow into complementary vibration. That's always good. And the other thing is always keeping the colors a little varied so it doesn't get boring. Yep, looking good. I had a little bit of this French ultramarine in the purple to give it so it's not too mauve-y. I like a nice blue-violet for these. Okay, here's the jewels. We're just gonna start laying them in, scooping this out, putting them in each one like that. Just work away across the canvas. Okay. All right. Santi, if you can turn the music down a little bit. So, it's pretty close to done. It's pretty happy. Hi. What we'll do is we're going to take a short break. Well, not a break, really. We're going to listen to the second half of Brandon Boyd's interview with Grace Cooper. And it's kind of fun. Brandon lives out in Topanga Canyon, just north of L.A. And as we were saying earlier, his studio is a yurt, one of those round tents, but not your average yurt. It's a pretty luxury yurt. And I think in this part of the interview, he actually takes her into it and takes us into it. So Marcus, if we're ready, let's roll Brandon and Grace interview part two.
So you can't really see this maybe off if you're on camera and if you're joining us for the interview, Brandon, you know, but it's quite textured, this artwork, which is, I think makes it that much more interesting.
Thank you. Yeah, it's fun. It'd be great if people could touch them, but I don't recommend it. Probably is it still wet.
And you've done, this is acrylic, watercolor, and oil on canvas, am I correct?
Yes, the oil pastel is kind of the almost crayon-looking stuff, brick reds. The acrylic is the black line and the beiges, and then the watercolor are, I did the eyes in watercolor, and I did them on a separate piece of paper, and then kind of adhered them to the painting itself to create another layer of tactile sensation. So you're right, it is very kind of tactile. It wants to be touched, even though you probably shouldn't touch it.
I know. You kind of do. It's like the forbidden fruit. You can't touch it.
Hey, what's up?
He guards my ear.
Oh my goodness.
He's not angry, he just misunderstood.
He's got a little bulldog sculpture next to him.
Do you not see it? Oh, hi.
Oh yeah, hold on. Wait.
Oh, there we are. Oh, lovely.
Anyway.
Okay, let's go. Okay, now we're going to go over to the second artwork, which was also brought to the gallery the other day. And this is on the ground running. And again, we have your, you know, we've used your eyes again. And this is quite similar to one of your other artworks from your previous series. I think it's Quarks.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, again, I love it when you use, you know, these really bright colors, like this beautiful cerulean, and again, you use the beige. And this is also watercolor, oil, and acrylic on canvas.
Yes.
And why did you choose On the Ground Running for the title?
There's something kind of, there's a movement in this painting. It looks like it. I just stepped back from it when I was sort of finishing it, and the thought occurred to me that it looked like it hit the ground running. And so I was like, I should probably call it The Ground Running, because it wanted to move the minute I started spinning out those lines and stuff. And I suppose this would be a really good piece to animate. And turn into a, what do they call it? An NSFW? Is that the new hot thing?
I'm not sure.
You're asking the wrong two girls.
That was my attempt at like a dad joke. It's called an NFT. If you guys, if you don't know what that is yet,
you're gonna. NFT, like the cryptocurrency.
Yeah, the non-fungible token.
Yes.
If you didn't know about it, and people know about it, they're gonna get flooded with this stuff.
I learned about it on NPR this morning.
Awesome. So I've been jokingly referring to them as NSF because that's a much more fun topic to me. But anyway, you look great animated.
It is extremely animated. I love it. It almost kind of looks like a wave running over and over each other again.
Mm-hmm.
And just like Polyamorous too, this one is raised as well, which you would have for those of you who are joining us who would have seen. Does anyone have any questions for Brandon or for us that you would like us to answer?
Well, somebody wanted to know if you had, Brandon, do you have one of the prints that you can show us?
Yeah, of course. I'm going to take you guys.
I'm signing all the prints, which is very exciting.
I'm almost halfway through signing.
So all the...
That way you can see what's going on.
Can you see? Can you see that?
Yes, I can. Oh, they look amazing.
So it's the original. Went. It sold really fast, so I don't actually have it here to show you. But like I was talking about before, in this image, the figure in the image, her eyes are obscured, which is sort of once again alluding to that contemplative state, but she's also in movement, which is kind of fun. And then all of the witnesses are these disembodied eyes, which are kind of like these small menacing creatures, and there's 11 of them, so.
11 eyes.
Yeah, I think I'm 70, no, I'm 88.
See, you're closer 200. Than you think. But we're really excited to have them. I mean, they look phenomenal. They looked amazing just to have on. Sorry. They look absolutely phenomenal, and we're super excited to have them. They are available on our website for those of you who are just joining us. But tell us kind of a little bit about, you know, what was your inspiration for doing another print? Have you kind of been more in this creative process while you're painting in the yurt? Which, it's nice to see the yurt again, by the way.
The yurt says hi.
Thanks.
I'm seeing a question come up on the bottom, and it asked if the print is only available at the gallery, and it's available starting today, right, through you guys?
Yeah, so it's on our website now, and if you are on Instagram, the link to our website is in our bio, and then tomorrow it will also be available on your website.
Yes, so the first 100 will be available starting now on your guys' website, second 100 will be available tomorrow, Saturday, on mine, yes.
Yes.
We did it.
Yay.
We did it.
Is there any work that you are working on currently that you might be able to talk about with us a little bit?
I just have pieces which are, oh, and there's someone about to chop something down outside, so that's unfinished as well. No, I have mostly like old pieces here. There's one gigantic one which nobody likes but me. You guys want to see it?
Yes, we do want to see it.
Jen, will you hold this so they can see it with me in scale? Thanks. Don't mind the mess. Jen did it.
Yeah, that's my fault.
See, look. Nobody likes it but me.
So Jen, get closer.
Okay.
If I'm 6 feet tall, it's like, what, 7 feet tall? 6.5? It's like, it's pretty big.
Wow.
Do you see?
Jen, can you go closer a little bit so you can see the detail of the artwork?
It's like a glorious mess.
Well, I like it, so you've got two fans now, including yourself.
Nice. Thank you.
Of course. So before we kind of conclude this and sign off, do we have any last minute questions or anything else that you would like to tell us or talk about?
Hi, people in Mallorca. It just said hi from Mallorca, Spain. I've always wanted to go there.
I'm so glad everyone's joining us from all over the world. Let's see if there's any questions for us. No, everyone just seems to be really excited about the two new artworks and the print. So, perfect.
I did see one question. They wanted to know if you've ever dabbled in anything besides painting, like sculpture.
I have, What's the stage before dabbling? I can't even call it dabbling. Someone has handed me lumps of clay, and I think I made a bong when I was like 14.
And so you may have done things with tinfoil.
Yeah, I may have created like penis sculptures out of clay before, but I wouldn't share them with anyone.
You never know, you might have a wide audience who'd
want to
see it. You never know.
You'd have a
dig
exhibit.
Could be
a
new series.
Yeah, exactly. I'm fascinated by sculpture, though, and it's something that I would very much like to dabble in one day. Sculpture fascinates me, so I think it's just a matter of time.
Well, that would be very exciting. And yeah. Is there kind of any maybe hint on the horizon of you doing a new book?
Yeah, that's a good question. I suppose that I've been working on my next book since I put out So the Echo in 2014. Was that when it came out? 2013. Oh my God, it's definitely time. So yeah, working on it.
Good. Okay, well, sorry. Aw.
You know the people in Texas.
There's your protege artist in the he's waiting for paint and direction.
Right. He's like, paint me like one of your French dogs.
Okay, everyone.
Hi.
Well, thank you so much, Brandon, for joining us. This was really a lot of fun to interview you again. I hope that soon we can do it in person. But I'm really excited about this new print. Super excited for everyone to see them online and to receive them in person. They are just phenomenal and super exciting. And then, of course, your two new artworks. A few people have seen them in the gallery today, and they really, really enjoyed them. So looking forward to many more people coming in to Dallas and viewing them. But thank you again, everybody. If you have any questions, please just email us. But thank you all for joining us. This was so much fun. Brandon, thank you.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you. Bye-bye.
Soon. Bye, everybody.
You're live.
Okay, everyone.
Is it over?
Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much for watching the second segment of the Brandon Boyd interview. I had so much fun interviewing him. I mean, I always have fun interviewing all of our artists, but to talk about his print release and to also talk about his new artwork.
You guys all come in here.
That was really, really
exciting. Are you going to make us do that?
Yes, I am.
I think JD and the rest of our team will be joining us in just a few minutes. I think I see JD about to come in, and we're going to talk about his painting, which I think, he completed it quite fast. You definitely finished it up in the 10 minutes.
What are you doing here? Okay.
Talking about how you finished it up in the 10 minutes.
Yeah, well, 67 years and 10 minutes, and I can do it as fast as you want. So I have one thing I want to put on here. You can stay up here while we do it, because we're almost done. Wow, great interview, by the way.
Thank
that was
you.
So cool.
It was so much fun to interview Brandon again. It's been a while since I did the last time. I think it was back in September.
Yep.
Was the last time we interviewed Brandon.
Yeah, and he's been basically hunkered down since then. I don't think he's left his yurt.
I think he's working on a new album.
Yeah, that's what he said.
So very exciting for all his fans.
All right, so here's what I'm doing, Grace. I'm going to add, I want to have a little bit of human. I need some white paint. Where can I find white? Right here.
Let's see, there you go.
Okay, so this is really cool, right?
But
I want to put a barn in there.
Ooh.
Yeah, I want there to be some foliage.
One of my favorite things about working at SLG, I mean, obviously it's an amazing job and it couldn't be better than anything else, but one of my favorite things about working here is to come back into the studio and see JD paint in person, because it really is such a really special, magical thing.
Well, thank you, Grace. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm doing is, when I first saw sunflowers, it was up in New York. Mm-hmm. They had these amazing old barns with the classic red roof.
Ooh.
And so that's what
I'm
we're
excited
doing.
To see how this turns out.
We're just putting a little, we're setting a little compound here. This is a very prosperous. They've got a lot of buildings in their,
wow,
their land. Right here, a little bit there. And then let's just put some fences in here. Yep. See how that just brought all of a sudden.
It really
now
does
it's alive.
Bring it all together.
Let's put a couple windows in there so we can see out of our house. Yep.
So now that you can see the painting up close, you can really see the texture that comes off of the canvas.
That's right.
Oh, it looks
and
so good.
Here's a farmer there. He's just walking to go get his cows. let's get some sunflowers all around him though.
Let's do it.
He's buried in sunflowers. Okay, I got to sign it. Then we're gonna wrap up the show. Hey, if I could get the SLG team up here, gather up here. Let's all come together and wrap up this show. Here we go. Let's sign it in the wet oil. Bam. Little sunflower action. Okay, and what is today? Three something.
It's the 11th, 12th.
Ah, Arturo's birthday, are you kidding me?
Yes.
How could I not know?
Got an SLG birthday over 3/12/21,
which reminds me, there we go. So, Arturo, can you get up here? Hey, someone grab this camera. Yeah, grab it, Travis. So we got our entire beautiful staff. How lucky are Arturo and I? Pretty freaking lucky, would you say?
Very lucky.
Yep. So we got Cecilia and Emily, our director, Kristen Rivas, Grace, Arturo. By the way, Emily just got promoted to assistant director, so congratulations to that. And Cecilia mans our gallery that we now have at the National Hotel downtown, so thanks for being there and inviting everybody in. But today is our operations manager's
birthday.
Date of birth. Yes. Yeah, birthday. How old are you, brother? Or do you want to tell?
I am 45 years old.
Wow, yes. 45. I love
I've been
it.
I'm blessed with 45 years old and hopefully many more.
Hell yeah. You know what? Yeah, yeah, yeah. And here's the thing. The older you get, the more grateful you are for another one, right?
I know.
So yeah, yes. Yep. And Arturo, yes, you knock you. It out of the park, brother. You're just killing you. It. We love you. Are we gonna have a cake or something later for this guy?
Well, it was a surprise.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, what are you gonna do? No, I'm just kidding. Nope, we're not having a cake for that guy.
Sorry.
Yeah. Well, guess what, guys? What do you think? Another good show?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
I think so.
And in April. April what dates, Kristen?
16th and 17th.
So 16th will be Reflection Friday with Tyler Shields out
We're
of Hollywood.
We're super excited.
He's going to be here in person. Can
yeah.
you believe it? We got all new work of his. He's in Sotheby's right now for his one-man
show. Dreaming Awake.
Oh, my God.
I mean,
God.
And it's amazing because he's the only living photographer ever to be honored with a show at Sotheby's.
A solo show.
Yeah.
That's incredible.
So it's very iconic.
Tyler Shields.
We're very excited.
Will be here in Yay. Dallas, Samuel Lynne Galleries, yes. April 16th, and then the 17th will be down at the National.
Yes.
Rocking out, right? Rocking the National downtown. All right, you guys happy?
Very happy.
Yeah, day wound up good, didn't it?
It did.
Here we go. Well, guys, thanks for tuning in. You know,
yes.
we're all a reflection of you, and thanks for just for supporting us. So we will see you April 16th.
Yes, we will.
With Tyler Shields.
See you next time, everyone.
All right.